Bring in Craig Anderson, fresh off the is the ink dry on the paper on the 2-year extension? Have you officially signed that 2-year extension yet? Congratulations, Craig.
Thank you. Yeah, no, we're just waiting here. Pierre was just gonna go over to his office here and finalize everything. But yeah, they've announced it, and we've all agreed to terms, and everyone's kind of happy with the way it all played out.
Do you get butterflies? Do you get nervous at this point of a process?
I wouldn't say butterflies, but definitely it's kind of get that that edgy feeling of just kind of like, it's hard to explain just kind of what the feeling is, but it's still exciting time for me.
You know what? We talked before you come on, Craig, at the start of the show about what your season was like last year. I think it's a great move for you to get it off the plate, but I think it's a better move for the Sens because you've got to be the key guy to get them in this year again.
Yeah, I think everyone kind of, I was prepared to come in here and just play it out and, just give everything I have to the Sens after the way they've treated me, especially after last year. They bent over backwards for me, and I owe them nothing but my best effort on the ice and my preparation, everything that goes kind of going into the game. There's no change in that. And, I felt after kind of how everything played out last year that I feel I can contribute and continue to contribute. And I still love the game and want to be, being away from the game those 2 months made me realize that how much you love the game. Because sometimes when you play in a long season, things can get kind of long in tooth. And they just, it kind of lit the fire kind of right back up when I had to watch the guys play for those 2 months.
How fearful were you that it would become a distraction during the season if you didn't sign?
I don't think it would have been a distraction at all. Like I said, I was prepared to come in here, and I had a current contract that was paying me to play, and my love for the game to come in here every day, just be with the guys, there would have been no distraction at all from my end of things. And, I come to work and put the work boots on and make sure that I'm giving everything I have to the guys in the room and on the ice and practice. And, I'm glad everything kind of got taken care of and we can just move on as well.
Craig, it's really interesting at this stage, with your age, you've become, we were talking about it earlier, your career really took off at almost 30 years of age, and you're getting better with age.
Yeah, I mean, I think following the footsteps of Tim Thomas here, just
don't move to a log cabin, okay?
Yeah.
Please,
no log cabins. There's no taking seasons off here. It's more of like I said, he came into the league a little later, and was able to thrive. His passion for the game and just kind of continued to allow him to continue to get better. And that's kind of the same path that I'm kind of on. And started a little bit later I've only played, half as many games as Luongo in the same kind of amount of time.
Wow,
so I've had to watch, and I've learned from watching in early in my career and using those tools to be able to play longer. I think I've become smarter as I got older and maybe a little bit less quick and less agile. But, by reading the game and being mentally sharper, it allows me to be a better player.
I was really worried you were going to drop a White House reference in there with the Tim Thomas comparison.
Oh,
too.
No.
Good,
yeah,
good.
No,
we've had enough of that.
I haven't even been thinking about that.
Craig Anderson's with us. Just signed a two-year contract extension with the Ottawa Senators. Now has 3 years this year and then the 2-year contract extension. You were able to step in seemingly out of nowhere last year, being with the family, and then jump right into the lineup and play so great. So I'm curious, from a preparation standpoint, what did you learn about yourself that allowed you to do that in compared to past years where I'm sure it was focus on the game?
I think it goes back to when I came to Ottawa and I saw Alfie having so much fun at the rink. And Alfie, when the puck dropped, he was 100% serious, mentally focused in the game, but he didn't allow the game to kind of overwhelm his life. When he got off the ice, it was fun in games, it was joking, it was just enjoying being around the guys. And I started to kind of learn that as I've been here, and I think that's part of the reason why I've been able to play, as well as I have over the last few years. And then last year really kind of was the aha moment was I was away from the game. You realize how much you love the game and how much you miss being around the guys. And that passion, that drive just got relit, like you were a 10-year-old kid jumping back on the ice. You're just so excited to be there. And I think when you enjoy what you're doing and you love the guys that you're playing with, it just elevates your game.
How good is your team this year compared to the one that went to the third round last year?
I'd like to think that we've improved. There's obviously areas, you know, you lose some pieces, you get some pieces. But, you know, here in the camp, we've had a lot of guys, a lot of young guys come in and really open the eyes. And from my watching, that can really play. And they're going to help us here in the short term and then definitely in the long term.
Craig, how much better can Carlson be? I mean, he has been so good, and I mean, he's had such a great start, but he just seems to be getting better all the time. How much better can he get?
I think the sky's the limit with him. He's, you know, the type of guy that sees the game better than everybody else. He sees plays that 99% of us can't see, and he makes plays that you stand back there and you giggle when he's on the ice when he makes some of these plays. And, you know, he's going to make mistakes. He always, you know, everyone makes mistakes, and but I think last year was kind of a turning point for me. Is that when he made a mistake, there was no negative body language. It was immediately like, I got to get back. I made a mistake. I'm going to make it up. And that's kind of where I've seen him grow as a player. And that's really what's kind of changed the whole culture of our room. Is when Carl's busting his butt, everybody else is busting their butt.
You know, and young Thomas Chabot can skate almost as well.
Thomas has been a real pleasure to play back there for behind him, because he's a guy that picks up the puck, he'll skate with it, he'll make an extra play. He's confident right now with the puck, and you know, he's got many years in front of him, but he's already shown that he can play well beyond his years.
Craig Anderson gets the 2-year contract extension. Two things before we let you go. The one is, when did you become aware that this was done? That this was you had to get to the office and make a signature here.
Late last night. I know I wasn't involved too heavily with kind of the off-ice, you know, negotiations. You know, my focus was training camp, get ready for the season, kind of let my agent, Justin, take care of everything. You know, and he called last night and kind of described kind of how everything played out. And he said, are you happy with this? And I said, 100%, let's just get it done and move on. And we're ecstatic about being a part of this organization and playing out the next 3 years.
So what do you do? What do you do at that moment? Do you hang up the phone and do high
fives? Before that, I call my wife and make sure that she's okay with it. Make sure the boss boss gives the go ahead. But I think it was one of those things where you just kind of like, I get to, you know, continue to play my childhood dream for another 3 years.